नमस्कार सत श्री अकाल आदाब और सभी का बहुत बहुत स्वागत है। वार्म वेलकम एट समाचार 24+। मैं एकता सैगल, फाउंडर मानस वेल्थ, अ फाइनेंशियल मेंटोर, मदरहुड क्लब, किडो मेंटरिंग पर आज आप सबके समक्ष हूँ समाचार 24+ के सीनियर एंकर और बोर्ड मेंबर की हैसियत से। जैसा कि आप सब जानते हैं कि हम आपको कुछ ऐसी शख्सियत से मिलवाते हैं जो कुछ अपनी जिंदगी में कर रहे हैं जो काफ़ी हटके हैं। दे आर मेकिंग अ डिफरेंस टू नॉट जस्ट देमसेल्व्स बट टू ऑल ऑफ अस, टू द मैनकाइंड। ऐसी एक शख्सियत से मैं आज आपको मिलवाऊंगी, बट इससे पहले कि मैं उनका इंट्रोडक्शन दूं, कुछ लाइनें, सम वर्ड्स कम टू माय माइंड दैट आई वुड लाइक टू रीड, बिकॉज दैट विल गिव यू द एसेंस ऑफ दिस जेंटलमैन हु हैज जॉइंड अस टुडे। सो लेट मी रीड आउट अ फ्यू लाइंस। दे से दैट इन्फेक्शियस इज द स्माइल ऑन अ चाइल्ड्स फेस। दे से ईच अदर एंड स्माइल इवन दो दे डोंट नो व्हाई। So pure is their heart, which reflects on their face. Wish we adult learn this art and face the tough time. 1 minute tear, the next second smile. Hold no grudge, laugh it off like a child. Life is too short to fuss and whine. So be the child who smiles all the while. वेल, आप सब लोग समझ गए होंगे कि हम बात कर रहे हैं खुश रहने की। हम बात कर रहे हैं कि सिर्फ एक झूठी हंसी अपने चेहरे पे ना रख के Be happy within yourself. How do we do that? Well, I don't know what the answer to that is, but we have someone who can make us all understand that how can one achieve all that they want to with one success mantra, which is happiness. So with a warm welcome, I'm going to invite Mr. Avinash Ananda. He's the co-creator of MetaMind Alignment, a leadership and happiness coach, a transformational coach, has touched the hearts of many. I think I am forgetting the count, but many, many people across the country, across the globe, and is very lovingly, very, very respectfully and affectionately called a guru. So Avinashi, a very warm welcome, because if I say anything beyond this, which would mean that I will read your profile, and I don't think that I can do it. Because if someone has to talk about themselves, it's the person himself or herself. So I welcome you on Samachar 24+ and would request you to please tell us a little more about yourself, because your profile is so illustrious that if I read it verbatim, I don't think I'm going to do justice to it. So let's hear a little bit about yourself.
Ekta ji, first of all, thank you very much for having me on your show, on your channel. It's an absolute pleasure and honor to be here. Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Secondly, when you spoke about reading out my profile, normally, I'm so happy you didn't read out my profile, because normally when people read out profiles, the other people switch off. Because profiles are long and profiles are meant to be something nice anyway. Nobody's going to invite somebody and say something bad about them. So people tend to switch off from that. So you're keeping it more real when you are talking from your heart instead of reading out something. So thank you very much for that. My introduction to myself, how do I do this? Huh? I'm a teacher. So I've been influenced by teachers all my life. It is said that if you have 5 good teachers in your lifetime, you consider your life to be blessed. So I've had several good teachers in my life, beginning with my parents, and then going on to my mentor, who, mere Guruji jo hai, wo, his name is Professor Rishi Kumar Pandya, and I refer to him in the present tense, although he left us several years ago. He's no more. But he is the one who influenced me since I was the age of 10. So 10 साल की उम्र में मैंने decide किया कि मुझे उनके तरह बनना है. And for 30 years, he mentored me.
Wow.
And this is how I was able to get into this field. And today I have an organization with about 40 trainers. So ye 40 trainers jo hai, they are behavioral scientists, psychologists. They've been trained by us in our organization. And we have I have about 80% of my work happening in corporates in Europe and America. Now, since COVID happened, last 3 years I've been in India, so we've started a lot of work in India also. So I guess people want more and more happiness because our business has grown 15 times in the last 3 years.
Wow. That's
that shows the need for happiness. While on one hand it looks very nice, ki business is growing, on the other hand it's not a very good sign because it shows that mental wellness ki zarurat kitni hai. You know, that is so important. Happiness is so important to people. But at least I'm glad people are realizing it.
Absolutely. I so agree with you. And I think the last 2 years, especially during the time of COVID, I think many of us have realized that while we've been paying attention to our physical health, it is of utmost importance that one pays attention to the mental well-being. And this, I think, is across the age group. Right.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Across geographies also, actually. Even across the world. Why you have that great resignation that was happening in the West? Because people are realizing that money is not everything. They have to take care of spending time with their loved ones. And not only when a crisis happens, then they think about these things. They have to think about make happiness a part of their daily life.
Absolutely. So, Avinash, you know, a very fundamental question that comes to my mind is that...
Yeah.
बचपन से ही हमें बोला जाता है, यू नो, एज अ चाइल्ड वी बीन ऑलवेज टोल्ड दैट यू नो बी हैप्पी, स्टे हैप्पी, कीप स्माइलिंग, हैव पॉजिटिविटी अराउंड यू. एंड लाइक आई सेड इन द बिगनिंग व्हेन आई रेड माय फ्यू लाइंस, यू नो, डेडिकेटेड टू योर प्रोफेशन, योर पैशन,
सो ब्यूटीफुल,
वी व्हाई डू वी फॉरगेट टू बी हैप्पी एंड टू स्माइल एज वी ग्रो अप एंड वी गेट कॉट अप इन द रैट रेस.
Perspective to this. You know, they say that human beings must go back to becoming like children. Because when we were children, we were happy. I say that we need to develop the childlike quality back in us. However, there are many things that we did as a... We should not be childish. We should be childlike. तो बचपन के जो बुरे क्वालिटीज है वो हमें नहीं होने चाहिए. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, डिपेंडेंस से हम इंडिपेंडेंस तक गए. नाउ वी हैव टू गो टू इंटरडिपेंडेंस, व्हिच इज आल्सो रियलिटी. सो आई एम सेइंग दैट वो चेहरे पे जो ग्लो जो होती है ना, जो रौनक आती है, द पीस और द हैप्पीनेस, यू सी इन टू टाइप्स ऑफ पीपल. वन इज इन स्मॉल किड्स एंड द अदर इज इन ओल्डर मोर वाइज पीपल. So that wisdom is what we need to bring back, I feel, is more important. And part of that wisdom is to learn something and to unlearn something. Only then we'll bring that back. See, the mind by itself is not naturally designed to be happy.
Oh, interesting. That's very interesting.
The mind, Ektaji, according to Western psychologists, see, West or East may be fark hota hai na, ki Western psychology ke hisab se, mind is divided into conscious mind and subconscious mind. I'm keeping it simple, I'm not going too complicated into this. So, for example, first theory of mind was given by Sigmund Freud. Where he said conscious mind hota hai, fir uske andar niche ek unconscious mind hota hai, but according to, and he called something called preconscious, which is in the periphery, no, in the side, in the middle of these two. But Freud ki jo unconscious mind ki theory thi, he said that everything that happens in our mind that we don't like, any trauma that happens, ya kuch bhi hame acha nahi lagta, we want to suppress that and repress that, that goes into unconscious mind, which is like a dumping ground. Then further studies were done and they found that नहीं, इसको subconscious mind बुलाएंगे. Subconscious mind में वो सारी चीजें होती है which are repressed, which may be positive or negative. So I'll just talk about these two types of mind, conscious and subconscious, so as to not get too technical. In India there are 16 types of mind, which can be divided into four, which is very, very interesting. Indian psychologists are only now beginning to be understood and accepted and brought into mainstream Western psychology. Ye mindfulness vagaira jo hai na, jo America mein itna popular ho gaya hai, this is nothing but a small part of Vipassana meditation by Goenkaji. That also they didn't understand the whole thing. It's very, very interesting field. But I'll just make it simple. Why I'm saying the mind is not designed to be happy is because conscious mind ke andar, there are many cognitive glitches. Cognitive glitches is defects in the software of the brain, of the mind. Naturally, on is pe kisi ne abhi hal hi mein ek साइकोलॉजिस्ट ने नोबेल प्राइज ऑफ इकोनॉमी उनको अवार्ड किया गया था इकोनॉमिक्स. ही हैज कम अप विद अ न्यू फील्ड कॉल्ड बिहेवियरल इकोनॉमिक्स. उसका एसेंस ये है कि ह्यूमन बीइंग्स मेक इरेशनल डिसीजंस, ह्यूमन बीइंग्स आर नॉट लॉजिकल. उनका कहना ये है एंड ऑटोमेटिकली द माइंड इज सच दैट वी मेक रॉन्ग डिसीजंस ऑटोमेटिकली. दीज आर कॉल्ड बग्स, जो कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर में होता ना, और केमिकल लोचा जो कहते ना मुन्ना भाई में. देर आर प्रॉब्लम्स इन आवर डिसीजन मेकिंग कैपेबिलिटी बिकॉज वी हैव मेनी बायसेस. एग्जाम्पल आई गिव यू, एक है कंफर्मेशन बायस. कंफर्मेशन बायस का अगर हम किसी चीज पे बिलीव करते हैं तो इफ समबडी प्रिवेंट्स अस विद कॉन्ट्ररी एविडेंस ऑल्सो वी विल नॉट अग्री विद देम. वी विल से नो नो यही सच है. वी रिफ्यूज टू एक्सेप्ट एनीथिंग दैट इज एंड against our pre-existing beliefs, जिसमें हम prejudices कहते हैं या अंधविश्वास के जो beliefs होते हैं. So we are not logical creatures. This is the problem with the conscious mind. Subconscious mind में क्या problem है? Subconscious mind is a seat of beliefs. हम जो भी believe करते हैं, that has been put into our mind by well-meaning parents, by society, depending on our culture. If we are brought up in India in a particular society, we will say meat eating is bad. If you same person is brought up in America, they say it's natural. So beliefs are not chosen by the people. They are because of the culture, because of the situation, because of circumstances. Many of these beliefs are not healthy beliefs. They are not empowering beliefs. And humne bhi nahi chuna, humne to chuna hi nahi ye beliefs. So many beliefs, I'm saying, are disempowering. So subconscious mind is messed up. Many of the decision-making software is messed up. Conscious mind is messed up. We are still operating. We had, at the back of our head, we have this fight and flight response. No? Fight and flight. When we are faced with a danger, wo purane zamane mein, when we were aborigines or when we were cavemen, at that time, if a lion came in front of us, we had to run away, flight. If somebody else came in front with whom we wanted to fight, we fought with that person. So, do hi response hua karte the, fight or flight. Today, the world is evolved, culture is evolved, but the brain is not yet evolved so much. So, आज भी, but only difference is there are no tigers, lions today. तो हम बॉस को देखते हैं तो हमारा फ्लाइट और फ्लाइट रिस्पॉन्स वो एक्टिवेट हो जाता है. Which is not going to be helpful. Or if you have a fight with your spouse, husband-wife ke beech mein koi fight hota hai, to wo anger aa jata hai. Or that, fright comes in. There are many more effective ways of dealing with the mind. So Dalai Lama says beautifully, the mind has to be trained to be happy. माइंड को अगर हम ऐसे ही छोड़ देंगे और सोचेंगे कि खुशी ऑटोमेटिकली आएगी, वो कभी नहीं आएगी. वी हैव टू ट्रेन आवर माइंड टू बी हैप्पी.
यस, सो यू वर टेलिंग अस अबाउट द फैक्ट दैट अबाउट द कॉन्शियस एंड द सबकॉन्शियस माइंड एंड यू नो हाउ आवर माइंड इज ट्रेन्ड टू बी नॉट हैप्पी. एंड आई कंप्लीटली एग्री विद व्हाट यू सेड बिकॉज behavioral economics, the behavioral finance. And since I am a financial mentor and I for the last 21 years have been interacting with many people for their investments, what you said is absolutely right. That, the human mind hangs on to these mental biases, those cognitive illusions that we have in our head, and we are so stuck up. Though if you ask anyone, they all feel that, we are a very rational person. We don't get impacted by all those negative emotions like greed and fear. But the reality is when you actually sit down and introspect, that's when you realize that the problem is not with the external environment. The problem lies within us. I think, you've explained it in a very lovely manner.
Ekta ji, I'm so happy to be talking to you because you have financial experience, you have experience dealing with children, you have experience dealing with mothers, and you also have that compassion that you want to do good for others, and that gives you happiness. So it's perfect for this subject.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. As you said that the human mind is so attuned to be unhappy, right? And that is one of the major reasons that there is stress, you know, across age, across gender. There is so much of change that is happening, which we as an individual are unable to accept and internalize. Now, you say that the perhaps the only success mantra in anybody's life is to be happy, right? And I think that it is important that we now start to understand that how can we be happy, even though life is not always going to be hunky-dory. So how do we train our mind? How does Metta Mind Alignment and Avinash Ananda help people to be happy?
I think it begins with the light of knowledge, with some insight into the working of the mind and the working of reality. I always say, I said, you must realize what is real and what is lies. And you need to do that with your real eyes. The realization, I think, out of some facts. Like, for example, people have it mixed up. They say that I will be happy when. When can be filled by anything. I'll be happy when I get married. I'll be happy when I get divorced. I'll be happy when I get a child. I'll be happy when my child grows up. I'll be happy when my child gets married. Uske bachche ke bachche honge tab I'll be happy. There's no end to the when. So, and that whatever that when is, there is a goal attached to it. Lakshya hota na. Ki ye jab hoga tab main khush. So that achievement of a goal is called success. So people say, general thinking is ki jab mujhe success milega, when I am successful, I will be happy. Which is one type of happiness, and that happiness is there. But the problem is that happiness is very short term. Because the moment you are successful, your next stuff comes up. The wants are never ending. So there is another type of happiness, which is the happiness before. Can we get happiness now? Can we train our mind to be happy now and be like a kamal in the kichad, be like a lotus in the muddy pond? Everything is not perfect around us, but still, can we be happy now? Because that happiness will be the energy that will take us forward towards more and more success. So we should use happiness as the magnet that will attract good people in our lives. See, people like to be with good people. People like to be with happy people, positive people. People don't want to be all the time with people who are crying and messed up in their lives. There are some exceptions. Some people like it. But generally, for long-term happiness, it is good to be happy right now and attract the right people in your life. Attract the right success in your life. And whenever things go wrong, which they naturally will, it has to happen, then use the energy of happiness to pick yourself up and coco. Coco is keep on keeping on. Jo kehte hain Hindi mein LR, LR. Lage raho, lage raho. For that, we need energy. And that energy can come from happiness. So this is my one thing that I'm suggesting, that we need to change our way of thinking. And instead of saying, I'll be happy when I get this, work on training the mind to be happy now and develop the positive energy now.
Lage raho, keep on kicking on. I think ye ek mantra hai jo shayad aaj hum sab log yahan se zarur leke jane wale hain. Aur bilkul sahi kaha Avinash ji ne ki hum hamesha khushi ke karan dhoondte hain. You know, we keep looking around us that what is going to make us happy. Ek bar apne andar jhaank ke dekhiye, shayad khushi wahin kahin baithi hui hai, aapka intezaar kar rahi hai. Aur kisi ne ek someone I know, you know, once had written a few lines where the essence of it was that khushi aayi unke ghar mein, happiness came on their door knocking, but the person said, go, you know, I'm looking for a bigger happiness. And every time happiness came, the person shooed off that happiness in anticipation that a bigger happiness is going to come. And thereafter, happiness said, you always shoo me away. I don't want to come. I was so that big happiness for you, which you didn't value. So I think, Avinash, so are you trying to say that in a sense, we have the power within ourselves to actually be happy and
absolutely
make our lives like the way we want.
Absolutely, absolutely. You hit the nail on the head, Ekta ji. It's like this chair, no? Manzile bahut hai, afsane bahut hai. Raha hai zindagi mein imtihan aane bahut hai. Mat kar gila uska jo naam mila. Zindagi mein khush rehne ke bahane bahut hai. Focus your mind to start looking for the good. Thank you. Focus your mind on start looking for the good in situations. There is no such thing as perfection. There was this man, he was 55 years old, and he met his friend in the restaurant, and his friend asked him, Shadi hui tumhari? He said, you are always saying, you are looking for the perfect woman, huh? Did you find the perfect woman? He said, I haven't got married yet, but I found the perfect woman. He said, why you didn't marry her? He said, because she was looking for perfect man. Right. So match kabhi nahi hoga is what I'm saying. What you think is perfect.
Avinash ji, thoda aapka network aa raha ja raha hai.
Can you hear me now?
थोड़ी कट गई, but I think जो अविनाश जी कहना चाह रहे हैं वो यही है कि perfection शायद हमें हमेशा नहीं मिलेगी.
जी जी, doesn't exist.
खुश होना ना होना हमारे हाथ में है. परफेक्शन को ढूंढेंगे तो परफेक्शन को ही ढूंढते रह जाएंगे, तो जो करना चाहते हैं लाइफ में वो आप कभी नहीं कर पाएंगे. तो मुझे लगता है अविनाश जी, आप ना हमें बहुत टेक्निकल चीजों को बहुत सरल तरीके से, बहुत सिंपल तरीके से आप हमें समझा रहे हैं कि भाई लगे रहिए खुशी. आप आई थिंक हैप्पीनेस इज सिनोनिमस टू अस. अगर हम उसको एक्सेप्ट करते हैं, अगर हम खुश रह सकते हैं, हमारे जो माइंड के जो बायसेस है, अगर हम उसको थोड़ी देर के लिए बाहर छोड़ दें और फिर जिंदगी को एक अलग नजरिए से देखें, तो शायद जिंदगी और खूबसूरत हो सकती है. तो अविनाश जी, एक बात बताइए, आपने करीबन 7 लाख से भी ज्यादा लोगों को ट्रेन किया है. आप बड़े बड़े कॉर्पोरेट हेड्स को ट्रेन करते हैं, एडुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस को ट्रेन करते हैं. तो जब आप उनको ट्रेन करते हैं, विच इज दैट वन की दैट यू गिव देम दैट जस्ट ट्रांसफॉर्म्स देम कंप्लीटली?
एकता जी, देयर इज नो वन की. There is a combination key, two keys are there. But ये दोनों keys को देने के तरीके अलग अलग है, which means that we do all kinds of workshops in order to give these two keys. But they're only two keys. But if you give the two keys as they are, people don't get it. But when you package the two keys, you give it in the form of activities, jokes, stories, and give it at the right time, then hopefully they get it. And they work. So I'm giving the two keys without the packaging right now. Okay. One key is objectivity. Objectivity ka matlab hai, jo Krishna Bhagwan ne Arjun se kaha tha Bhagavad Gita mein, have drishta bhav aur sakshi bhav, or be a witness. Look at the situation from the outside. Or Stephen Covey ne isse kaha tha, usko kaha tha third alternative. Ki don't always look ki ya to ye, and my options are limited. Your options are never limited. Agar aap objectively dekhenge kisi situation ko, to aapko samajh mein aa jayega ki ye to hai kuch nahi, ye zyadatar psychodrama hai. It is maya, it is leela, it is a play of the mind and emotions. Emotions are like bubbles, they come and they go. Emotional hoke agar humne kisi ko ek SMS kar diya, hamara emotion chala jayega, anger ya gussa ya upset, lekin wo SMS hamesha rahega. Isliye hum kehte hain ki when you are upset, when you are emotional, don't take any action. Don't take any nirne, don't take any decision. Wait for a while. Or you wait. So, ek hi message hai, main keh raha, pause. When you are upset, when you are anxious, whatever is happening, us waqt kuch mat kijiye, because at that time you are operating from a imbalance. You have to come back into some kind of mental stillness, sthirta, which will happen if you pause and become objective. इसको बाहर से देखिए, ये देखिए कि अभी एकता जी और अविनाश बात कर रहे हैं. नो, लुक एट इट फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड, लुक एट इट फ्रॉम द व्यूअर पर्सपेक्टिव. सो दिस इज नंबर वन की, ऑब्जेक्टिविटी. इट्स वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू गेट, बट इट्स वेरी पावरफुल. रिश्ता भाव, विच कैन हैपन इफ यू पॉज. द सेकेंड की इज ओनरशिप. ओनरशिप मतलब डोंट बी ओनली अ स्पेक्टेटर, बी अ प्लेयर इन द गेम ऑफ लाइफ. आजकल सोशल मीडिया के माध्यम से सब प्रेस वाले हो गए हैं, बन गए जर्नलिस्ट, बन गए सब क्रिटिक, बन गए हर चीज का. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द क्रिटिक इज नेगेटिव एंड अनोनिमस. सो पीपल पुट नेगेटिव अनोनिमस नॉनसेंस, दे वॉमिट आउट ऑल दैट नेगेटिविटी एंड स्प्रेड इट ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. So corona was negative, as a virus. People's negativity is negative. I'm saying we should make happiness go viral. Ye mission hai. Make happiness go viral. And the way to do that is don't point your finger and say, he's bad, he's bad. Remember, three fingers are pointing back at you. One finger is pointing at God, right? So I'm saying ki don't blame others. खुद पे रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी लीजिए. इफ यू से माई बॉस इज लाइक दैट, ठीक है, ही इज लाइक दैट, व्हाट कैन आई डू टू चेंज. माई वाइफ इज लाइक दैट, ओके, व्हाट कैन आई डू टू चेंज. माई हस्बैंड इज लाइक दैट, मेरे बच्चे सुनते नहीं है. बच्चे नहीं सुनते तो मैं क्या कर सकती हूँ, मैं क्या कर सकता हूँ कि मैं अपना अपनी काबिलियत बढ़ाऊ. कैन आई इंक्रीज माई क्षमता, कैन आई इंक्रीज माई केपेबिलिटी टू इन्फ्लुएंस देम मोर. So I am all for taking ownership of how to increase your capability to change things. Gandhi ji ne kaha na, be the change you wish to see. तो टेक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, डोंट गिव, डोंट से कि अरे सरकार बुरी है, ये बुरा है, ये बुरा है, एवरीथिंग इज बैड. देन व्हाट आर यू कंप्लेनिंग, यू आर नॉट टेकिंग चार्ज. आई एम सेइंग टेक चार्ज. सो इफ यू हैव दिस दृष्टा भाव और ऑब्जेक्टिविटी, विच मीन्स यू नो कि कौन सी चीजें ऐसी हैं जो बदली नहीं जा सकती एंड कौन सी ऐसी चीजें हैं जिसमें जिसको हम आज बदल सकते हैं, और कौन सी ऐसी चीजें हैं जिसमें वी हैव टू इंक्रीज आवर केपेबिलिटी टू बी एबल टू चेंज इट. इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल सेरेनिटी प्रेयर. गॉड ग्रांट मी द व्हाट यू रिमेंबर दैट, ग्रांट मी द करेज टू चेंज दैट व्हिच आई कैन चेंज, ग्रांट मी द सेरेनिटी टू एक्सेप्ट व्हाट आई कैन नॉट चेंज, एंड ग्रांट मी द विजडम टू नो द डिफरेंस. सो दिस इज द टू कीज, ऑब्जेक्टिविटी एंड ओनरशिप. इसको अगर हम एक्टिवेट करेंगे ना, तो हम कहते हैं कि हमारा कॉन्शियस माइंड सबकॉन्शियस माइंड तो है ही मेस्ड अप. देयर इज अनदर माइंड दैट वी हैव कॉल्ड आवर चित्त, व्हिच इज आवर मेटा कॉन्शियस माइंड, जिसको हम कहते हैं मेटा माइंड. इसको अगर हम एक्टिवेट करेंगे ना, तो ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स विल डिसअपीयर इंस्टेंटली. Because we are seeing the situation not from a drama perspective, but from the audience perspective. Number one. Number two, इसमें जो बदल सकते हैं उसको बदलने की कोशिश करते हैं. We don't stop. We don't just leave it and say, okay, मैं कुछ नहीं कर सकता. My life is like that. कर्म, जो English में उसको कर्मा कहते हैं, destiny, which is actually in Sanskrit, karma, which is action. Our actions create our destiny. Our decisions determine our destiny. This is the message.
Yeah. Absolutely. Objectivity and
ownership.
Ownership. Two O's जी. That जी. Mr. Avinash Ananda has shared us. सोचते ही सोचिए कि हमें ऑब्जेक्टिव होना है और हमें अपनी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी नहीं, ओनरशिप लेना है. कहने को दो आसान शब्द हैं और वही दो चाबियां हैं जो आज अविनाश जी ने हम सबके साथ शेयर की हैं. लेकिन क्या ये वाकई में इतना सरल है कि हम अपनी जिंदगी में ऑब्जेक्टिविटी और ओनरशिप ला सकते हैं? क्योंकि अगर ऐसा होता तो शायद आज हम सब खुश होते और पूरा जो देश है, पूरा जो विश्व है, वो शायद परेशान नहीं होता, तकलीफों से हताश नहीं होता. पीपल वुडंट कमिट सुसाइड्स, पीपल वुड नॉट गेट फैसिनेटेड विद वन फेलियर इन लाइफ. कई लोगों का मानना है अविनाश जी कि फेल नहीं होना चाहिए, हमेशा हमें सक्सेसफुल होना चाहिए. एंड यू नो वी शुड ऑलवेज कीप एडवांसिंग, कीप एडवांसिंग. बट आई वांट टू आस्क यू समथिंग, यू नो, व्हिच आई फील एंड आई वुड लाइक योर यू नो द वैलिडेशन और करेक्ट मी इन माय अंडरस्टैंडिंग. द वे आई लुक एट फेलियर, बिकॉज वन कैन नॉट ऑलवेज बी rising constantly, right? Life is a roller coaster, right? At the same time, problems will come and go. So I believe that if one fails, it is something that we actually take some forward actions, and there is a lot of inward learning. That's my definition of fail. And I think when you take forward action and when you learn something, जैसे कि आपने कहा कि हम वहाँ पे फिर ownership लेते हैं, कर्म की बात आती है. अगर when we act, that's when our destiny gets created. So am I right? Thinking that actually it is important to fail in life to eventually achieve that success through the happiness route, or I should be thinking differently?
Bhaktaji, you are superb. Actually, it's about having the insight and understanding there is no such thing as failure. People glorify success and they vilify failure. But failure jaisi koi cheez hai hi nahi. Every step in life is either a step forward or it is a learning experience. There is no such thing as failure. Failure is only an experiment gone wrong. Science mein experiments karte hain. Experiment agar sahi nahi aata. For example, Thomas Edison, one of the greatest inventors of modern history, no? He had 1,097 patents to his credit. And many people know the story. Ki 10,000 baar wo fail kiya unhone before he could invent the light bulb. 5,000 times when he failed, everybody knew about it. Everybody was laughing at him. They said, sir, why do you persist in this madness? Don't you know that man is destined to live life by the oil lamp? And electricity jaisi koi cheez aane wali nahi hai. There will be no lamp. He said, young man, reporter ko kaha usne, ki you don't understand the way the world works. I have not failed 5,000 times. I have successfully identified 5,000 ways in which it doesn't work, which brings me 5,000 ways closer to the way in which it works. So unless we fail, we cannot succeed. But there is no such thing as failure. So you're absolutely right. But why do we need happiness? Happiness is the energy that allows you to pick yourself up and LR, coco, when you fail. Failure तो होना ही है, but वो energy हमें कहाँ से मिलेगी? लोग give up क्यों करते हैं एक दो बार fail करने के बाद? Because many people don't know Thomas Edison, 17,000 times he failed before he found latex, out of which the entire rubber industry, tire and everything is made. Thomas Edison did that 17,000 times. How many people have that power to persist for so long? Which requires hope. Tu kehta na duniya umeed pe qayam hai. Hope is H-O-P-E. Happiness ki energy honi chahiye. O is optimism. Ye believe karna chahiye ki kuch bhi hua, aage to achha hoga. Optimism. P is progress. Ye dekhna chahiye ki, see, make mistakes, fail, but don't make same mistakes. Make new mistakes. Fail in different ways. Don't fail in the same way. There is progress. Progress hona chahiye. Aapke failure mein bhi progress hona chahiye. And E is excellence. Ki har baar hum jab kuch karte hain, wo pehle se behtar hona chahiye. There should be excellence in what we do. Not to prove to anybody. And then this hope will take us forward and make us succeed one day. That one day, when will it come? God knows. Aap lage raho, with energy, with, and have the happiness in the journey.
Wow. So I was actually writing it down.
Lovely.
Happiness, optimism, progress, and excellence.
Haan ji, haan ji, hope.
Mujhe lagta tha, hope means holding on to promises forever. But
aapne
definition hope ki di hai. And I think jo is acronym hope ko samajh jayega, jo two O's ko samajh jayega in its entirety.
Jee.
Ke paas khushi hamesha rahegi. लेकिन इतना आसान नहीं है. उसके लिए आपको अविनाश जी से मिलना पड़ेगा और उनसे कोर्स करने पड़ेंगे, समझना पड़ेगा कि कैसे आप जिंदगी में खुश रह सकते हैं, उस उम्मीद पे आगे बढ़ सकते हैं. और फेल जैसी कोई चीज नहीं है, जैसा कि अविनाश जी ने कहा, क्योंकि जब हम फेल होते हैं तो हम एक्चुअली कुछ सीखते हैं. और हमारे अंदर, अगर मैं आपकी इजाजत से अविनाश जी इसमें तीन पीज ऐड कर दूं आपके दो ओज के साथ, जिसमें मेरा Persevere, passion and panache. Persevereance, passion and panache. Kya baat hai, kya baat. Lovely. And aapne ek bahut important baat kahi thi ki we need to educate ourselves. So I think if we are objective, we take ownership, we persevere, we are passionate, we do things with panache, and we educate, empower and enlighten ourselves. So I think the OEP. अब इसका अगर OEP अगर आप देखेंगे और इसमें आप होप को भी ऐड कर दीजिए, आई थिंक लाइफ इज गोइंग टू बी एब्सोल्युटली ब्यूटीफुल. एंड अविनाश जी, नो वंडर दैट वेरी रिसेंटली यू वर फेलिसिटेटेड इन न्यू दिल्ली एज द वर्ल्ड्स लीडिंग बिहेवियरल एक्सपर्ट एंड मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर अवार्ड 2020-22. एंड आई थिंक जितने भी हमारे दर्शक इस वक्त आपको सुन रहे हैं या सुनेंगे बाद में, वो समझ सकते हैं कि एक छोटी सी चिड़िया जिसका नाम है खुशी, हैप्पीनेस, प्लेस सच एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड अ ब्यूटीफुल रोल इन आवर लाइफ. तो अविनाश जी, थोड़ा सा मैं, हमें तो हमने बात की कि आप अभी कैसे लोगों की लाइफ को ट्रांसफॉर्म कर रहे हैं. आपने शुरू में कहा था कि आपके गुरु थे, 10 साल की उम्र से आप उनसे प्रभावित हुए एंड यू इट चेंज्ड योर लाइफ.
दैट्स राइट.
व्हाट चेंज्ड व्हेन यू मेट हिम? व्हाट वाज दैट मैजिक मोमेंट?
I was 10 years old. My sister was 8 years old. My father was a corporate professional. My father, I belong to a middle class family in India. We are Sindhis. So at the time of the partition of 1947, my father was a young kid. He was 10 years old at that time. They came to India. We were settled. Sindhis are all over India, no state of their own. So they were in Bangalore at that time. Didn't have much money. My father wanted to be a doctor, lekin wo doctor nahi ban paya kyunki there was limited money in the house. He wanted to educate his brother. So his brother became engineer and dad remained salesman. And he grew the ranks and then he became corporate professional. He retired as a director, self-made man. But my father loved to learn. And he always used to give this message, which I always give. Learn, unlearn, relearn. Zindagi bhar is continuous learning, unlearning, relearning. And he used to attend many, many seminars. And he used to take us along with him, the family. He used to become friends with the seminar teachers over there, and he used to invite them home, and used to, because that would be a way for him to learn more and more. The more in touch you are with good people, the more you can learn. So I was 10 years old. My sister was 8 years old. There was Rishi Kumar Pandyaji with his long hair and rings, doing his seminar in front of the audience, and big suited booted sare log the wahan pe, corporate professionals, and they were listening to him with, you know, respect and attention, and they were laughing at the jokes, and I heard that Rishi uncle ban gaye hamare liye. Rishi uncle used to travel all over the world and give these seminars there, and used to live a great life, and used to play sitar, you know, 25 days in a month play sitar, 5 days in a month give seminar. This is his life. So I went up to him in the break time, and I told him, I said, Rishi uncle, I want to become like you. So he started laughing. He said, 15 din baad aao, if that feeling is still there, then we will talk. Okay? Because in that josh of the moment, everybody wants to be like someone. So I went to him, I said, I still want to be like you. He said, can you teach me? He said, of course. He said, you can be better than me if you work at it. And that's how the journey started. Every year I used to go to Mumbai. My parents used to take me over there, and I used to go to his house in Warden Road, Akash Ranga, and I used to learn from him. I used to travel with him. Wo jahan jaate the, main wahan chala jata tha. I used to, so at the age of 17, I conducted my first training program.
Wow, amazing.
Called Make It Happen. That was the story.
Wonderful. So, you know, I think... very nicely explained that age where everybody is so impressionable. You meet someone who transforms you. And I think you didn't stop at that. You took on that journey. You embarked on that journey and have gone ahead and transformed so many people. And, you know, you call him your guru and people now address you as guru. I think the chain continues, that mission of... making happiness viral, which is your motto, is actually...
Ittaji, even you are a guru. Ittaji, anybody who gives any light, because the traditional definition of guru, you know, in Sanskrit, no, one who dispels darkness and brings in the light of knowledge. So any of us who are able to give any knowledge or show the path to others, as we realize it, without any false claims, with our sincerity of heart, with our compassion, we're all gurus.
Absolutely. I so agree with you. So Avinash ji, as much as I would love to talk to you more and more and to understand more about being objective, being, you know, taking ownership of oneself. And as you rightly said, you know, two simple words, but there is a lot more. The packaging, the exercises, the experiential learning of that is there. It's, I'm sure, is a lot more than what you shared with us. But keeping the time constraint in mind, before I let you go, I'd like you to give a message out to all the viewers at Samachar 24 Plus that this is what Avinash Ananda Guru told me, and this can change my life. What would be that one message?
The one message would be through a Sanskrit shloka. And after the shloka, I'll give you the message, please, very quickly. Amantaram aksharo nasti, nasti mulam anaushadam. Ayogya purusho nasti, yogita statra durlabha. Amantaram aksharo nasti means there isn't a single letter of the alphabet from which a mantra or holy hymn cannot be made. Amantaram aksharo nasti, nasti mulam anaushadam is according to Ayurveda, which is the fifth Veda. There isn't a single root of a tree from which a jadi bhuti or a herb, medicinal herb, cannot be made. Ayogya purusho nasti, there isn't a single individual who does not have the potential for greatness. So through your medium, Samachar 24, and to all your viewers, I want to tell them, every individual watching has the potential for greatness. Do not believe anybody who tells you you are less. Don't settle for less than what you can be. Make your life the masterpiece it deserves to be. Remember, you are fantastic. As Swami Vivekananda said, and this is, we crossed our 75th year of independence, so I say, he said, arise, awake, stop not till your goal is reached. But for that, you need to believe in yourself. You need to believe in your country. You need to believe in your Sanskriti, in your culture, in your values. Don't allow the other people to put you down, because that's how they go up. But don't allow that to happen. Anybody who tells you something good, believe them about yourself. Okay? Be your own best friend. Believe in yourself and keep moving. Coco, keep on keeping on. Amantra Bhakshara Nasti Nasti Mula Manavashadram Ayogya Purusha Nasti. There isn't a single individual who doesn't have the potential for greatness. Yojakastatra Durlabha means what is Nayab, what is rare, what is Durlabh, what is difficult to find, is the person who can make the mantra out of the akshar. The person who can make the medicinal herb out of the root of the plant. That is rare. The person who can bring out the best in you, a mentor, a guru, a teacher, that is rare. And if you find, as I told you at the beginning of the program, five such teachers, if you find even five such teachers who are able to bring out your best, consider your life blessed. Huh? You have one today in the form of Avinash. You have another today in the form of Ektaji. Right? So find good teachers. When you find good teachers, learn from them. Be like a sponge. Keep on learning, keep on applying with objectivity and ownership. Your life will be in alignment with happiness. Thank you very much.
That's such a powerful message, and I think this is not just for our viewers, but it is also for the entire team of Samachar 24 Plus also, because we are growing, we are learning, and sure. Our founders, Hani Sehgal and Vikas Kumar Jha, are young boys who are progressing ahead in life. And I think, Avinash ji, I would also request you, to give us some insight of your association with Samachar 24 Plus and your message for these two young, vibrant entrepreneurs who are trying to make a difference to the lives of many.
These two young, vibrant entrepreneurs, they met me when I was receiving some other award in Delhi, some best motivational speaker award. They met me over there. And then I like them very much because they have this, they have an energy that can best be described as guts. Guts. Guts is G-U-T-S, genuine urge to succeed. Ek fire hai unke andar, dil ke andar. I've seen that in them. There's a beautiful thing I heard. Kya kehte ho? Pairon mein chakkar, muh mein shakkar. There is always moving, but muh mein shakkar, in politeness, in respect, is no nice way of talking. Pairon mein chakkar, muh mein shakkar, sar pe barf, which means there is a coolness in the head, but there is a clarity ki kahan pahunchna hai, kya karna hai, wo soch samajh ke karte hai. And aur dil mein aag. So this is the qualities I saw in both these young guys, Hani and this guy, and Vikas. And I loved it. I loved the people. So I said, I'll be happy to help them in any way possible. And I wish them the very, very best. And I wish you the very best. And I'm so happy that you are associated with them.
Thank you so much. And शुरू में जो मैं अविनाश जी से बात कर रही थी तो उन्होंने कहा था कि वो हिंदी में इतने कंफर्टेबल नहीं है, लेकिन वो जिस तरीके से उन्होंने संस्कृत का श्लोक हमें सुनाया और हिंदी के कुछ कुछ जो कहते ना तुकबंदी की या कुछ एक कविता के माध्यम से जो उन्होंने बात कही है, अविनाश जी आपकी हिंदी भी काफी अच्छी है. एंड यू नो आई थिंक आपका जो मैसेज है, आपकी जो विशेज हैं समाचार 24 प्लस के लिए, हनी सहगल के लिए, विकास कुमार झा के लिए, वो वाकई में बहुत मायने रखते हैं. एंड व्हेन यू हैव द राइट गुरु, द राइट मेंटोर विद oneself, I think there is nothing stopping you. And the way you have described the word guts is outstanding. I just loved it. I'm going to again listen to this conversation and, you know, make a note of a lot of points which perhaps would have missed because I was talking to you and so engrossed listening to it. But absolutely a pleasure speaking to you. And I thank you so much for the entire team of Samachar 24 Plus. I think you've just raised the bar for Samachar 24 Plus with these amazing insights. And each one of us who will hear you will definitely progress, will advance, and we will also make every possible effort to make happiness viral. That is our pledge for you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Pleasure talking to you.
जी तो हमारे सभी दर्शकों, I'm sure आपको आज की ये बातचीत बहुत महत्वपूर्ण लगी होगी. खुशी ढूंढिए नहीं, खुशी आपके भीतर ही है. बस थोड़ा ऑब्जेक्टिव रहिए, ओनरशिप लीजिए. होप जो है, जो उम्मीदों पे जो दुनिया कायम है, हैप्पीनेस, ऑप्टिमिज्म, प्रोग्रेसिव एंड एक्सलेंस, इन शब्दों के सही मायने में मतलब समझिए तो जिंदगी आपकी खुशहाल है. और ये जो आज मंत्र हमने सीखे हैं, ये सिर्फ हम बड़ों के लिए नहीं, सिर्फ महिलाओं के लिए नहीं, पुरुषों के लिए नहीं, बल्कि हर एक उस इंसान के लिए है जो इस जिंदगी में जन्म लेके आया है और एक पर्पस, एक मिशन के साथ आया है. तो आज मैं अपनी वाणी को यहीं विराम दूंगी और उम्मीद करती हूं कि आपको आज की ये बातचीत पसंद आई. और ऐसे ही हम आपको इंस्पिरेशनल लोगों से मिलवाते रहेंगे जिनकी जिंदगी से हम अगर कुछ सीख पाए तो हम सबका वो बहुत सौभाग्य है. तो अविनाश जी, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. एंड सभी को स्वतंत्रता दिवस की बहुत बहुत बधाई. और उम्मीद करती हूँ कि अमृत, आज़ादी का अमृत महोत्सव अगले 25 साल हमारे देश के लिए खूब खुशियों से भरे हों, सभी के लिए हों. और सभी लोग तिरंगे को सलाम कीजिए, उसका मान रखिए और स्वतंत्रता दिवस को मनाइए. Thank you so much. Signing off for today. Ekta Sehgal.
India will be a superpower very soon.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, everyone. Take care.